Good afternoon, everyone. So, Enrico is a guy with many hats in Debian, and I didn't expect it, but he will talk about a new hat, the Debian contributor hat. So, please welcome Enrico.
I'm chief weapons are Debian developers. Debian developers and Debian maintainers are two weapons. Debian developers and Debian maintainers and audio accounts. Our three weapons are Debian developers, Debian maintainers, audio accounts, and by report. Amongst our weaponry are such elements as Debian developers, Debian maintainers, audio accounts.
Nobody. That's a contribution to the social contract.
Nobody expects Debian contributors. Amongst our weaponry are such diverse elements as Debian developers, Debian maintainers, audit accounts, bug reporters, and maybe list contributors. Oh man, there's more possible. We clearly need another hat to make sense of all this. Right? So, let's make a new hat. I would like to create a hat of Debian contributors, so that we can say, nobody expects Debian. Our chief weapon are Debian contributors, full stop. A hat for everyone that contributes to Debian. Now, the details are here. This is the file with notes. Is it readable at the end?
No.
No? You have much better eyesight than that. No, sorry, I opened it in a different terminal. apologies. okay. That's that. Right. This is the text file with notes about what I plan to do. I would like to go through it with you and then edit it together with you. And at the end of this 45 minutes, have a proposal that I'll try to implement during that conf and fail, unless somebody helps me, probably. But anyway, we'll see how much of this we want to do, how much of it can be implemented during that conf, and at the end of that conf, I'll make another talk about what we changed in that year. So, this is probably a good time to... Okay, so the problem we want to solve, the problem I want to solve, and you probably also want to solve, once you realize you have a problem, is word wrapping. Now that we solve word wrapping, in Debian, we have lots of contributions that we do not thank people for. In the sense that we do not acknowledge that people that did translations worked. We don't acknowledge somewhere people who did translation or people who reported bugs. There's lots of contributions outside of Debian, but if we look around the package tracking system, Debian developer, package overview, it's all package based because that's where we come from, and so we track uploads, they're easy to track, and we acknowledge uploads mostly. There's so much more that we do not acknowledge at the moment. Also, there is time, we created so many ways of contributing to Debian that outside being a Debian developer, so the head of the Italian translations in Debian is not a Debian developer. Nobody knows who she is. Well, I know who she is. Francesca told me. And there's at least two Debian developers that know who she is. I have no idea who's the head of the Vietnamese translation. Raise your hand if you know who is the head of the Vietnamese translation in Debian. I assume, yeah, we all know who the French one is. But we totally need a way to credit people properly. Debian is so much more than uploads and cheese and wine box. So there's this idea of creating a hat of Debian contributor, which is the ultimate duocracy hat. There is no bureaucracy involved. If you contribute to Debian, you are a Debian contributor. Automatically, there is no new Debian contributor process. If you stop contributing to Debian, you stop being a Debian contributor. That's it. When you are a Debian contributor, you get such diverse privileges as having your name on a list of Debian contributors. And possibly, if you are not a Debian contributor anymore, then your name will be on a list of Debian contributors in 2012. And if we want to be really fancy, when you click on a name on a list, you get a page about that person that lists what they've done. And that's about it. That's all I had in mind. You report a bug, you become a Debian contributor. Then maybe everything you do for Debian is reporting a bug on the 11th of August 2013, then you will be a Debian contributor from the 11th of August 2013 to the 11th of August 2013. At least you are acknowledged as having helped Debian. I've said all of this. In order to do this, there needs to be a way of collecting this information. There are data sources we can easily tap into, such as package upload. But we can see mailing list traffic easily. We can get bug tracking system activity, hopefully easily. We can hook into commit logs of Alioth version control systems.
Sorry.
All right. At least I don't have to answer. Can I go? And this system, whenever at any point of its usage, will be unfair because there will always be some bit of Debian that isn't yet providing data for the list. However, the point is that by having such a system in place, we create a proper way of acknowledging people's work, and we give motivations for teams to contribute contribution information to the list. Questions so far? Sorry, I didn't understand the second part.
Wouldn't this raise privacy concerns?
Right. Good question. The question is, if we collect this data automatically, would there be privacy concern? Yes, possibly. To be discussed. All the information presented here is already public. There's a public record of package uploads, mailing lists are publicly archived, but the BTS is fully in the open, commit logs on Alioth are public. I would only mine or get data from sources that are either public or that people agree to disclose. However, it's the usual issue of the information is public but not presented in that way. For example, when I collected information from Debian changelogs to see the history of people's contribution in the process, I did not make it that information publicly available because it's a bit, I would want to have a discussion whether we want to present that information in collated in such a way. So yes, that is an issue. My general idea would be that once this system goes public, there should be a way for people to opt out of having information about them displayed. Most of the privacy scenario, so generally people, I would understand that generally the default would be that somebody likes their work to be credited. However, there may be people that would have issues if some of their work is credited. Most things revolve around job hunting, like recruiters looking at the internet, and you either want to be found, or if you don't want to be found, you already have a problem when contributing to Debian. I need to be careful about contributing with a different name or something. But yes, my assumption is that it's not a big privacy issue to get this started, as long as we give people an opportunity to opt out. Does it seem reasonable?
Maybe whether opt-in, but by default it's not opt-in.
I would be fine with opt-in. I wonder how many people would know that they can opt in and how to opt in. At the moment, the current Debian infrastructure is not even opt out. You can't say, please don't show the messages I sent to Debian mailing lists. I would see it surprising that such a thing would be opt-in, because everything's already out by default. On the other hand, I could be convinced about making it opt-in. It seems to be, at the moment, something that would impact the start of such a project. So before somebody gets a useful list, I would need to go and bother 1,000 people locked in the system so that that list can get populated. Yes?
I think you should also look at legal aspects. You are collecting personal information. As far as I don't know the law by heart, but as far as I understand it, it would be illegal in half of all European countries.
Then mapping is already illegal.
No. Currently, you are not collecting this information.
Yes,
you have it at different pieces and at different places where it is necessary. You have it in a bug report because the person wrote it there. And it's that...
The package tracking system would be illegal.
No, this would be
illegal.
You don't collect information there when you collect it for the person. There you have it to for specific purpose. And this is not illegal. But if you collect it and collect all information for a specific person or for all persons and collate it, this could possibly be illegal, as far as I understand it.
You said that you're not sure. I would like to talk with somebody who is sure. Because we already have things that would potentially be illegal in that view, like the package tracking system goes beyond a listing that somebody uploaded, because it collects information about everything visible about the person, bugs and so on.
Would it be, so I've researched that it's useful to bootstrap this kind of thing by having some reasonable set of people listed as contributors. You could start out by assuming that people who have said, I would like to be a Debian developer or I would like to be a Debian member have implicitly given their authorization to be listed as Debian contributors. It's a subset of that. We might have to run that by a lawyer, but it seems a bit more reasonable than anybody who's pushed to do that.
I was just going to say, I think the legal thing should probably be separated off, because in practical terms, if you are only worried from a legal point of view, you just need to get someone who's in Debian in the US to do this on a US server, because the US doesn't basically have these kinds of laws. The relevant question is, I think, not about the legal thing as a kind of red herring, but about what we want to do and what we think is fair and so on.
Well, I keep thinking we're doing something much more lightweight than Launchpad is doing.
Another way to enable this would be to do this automatism without publishing the data, but with afterwards sending about once a year or even possibly less a mail to every contributor if he wants to be listed. So we have an opt-in instead of an opt-out. If we do it seldomly enough, it would not even be so stressing people.
Yeah, that makes sense.
You don't need to wait a year, you can do it the first time you detect someone new, someone starts contributing, you can send, hello, we detected you did something in Debian, we would like to credit you,
wait for a month after the first contributions, if you get more, then, say you want to be thanked. Makes sense.
Or even without waiting, that's what's done for the Linux kernel. You know the stats about which companies contribute to the Linux kernel? It's not like that. They check for new commits and just send an email to ask for affiliation.
There's other systems that calculate karma. Those are illegal because then they produce information that could be used to rank people from a job point of view. I'm not that concerned with the legality at the moment.
Would that credit also only be for persons, also for organizations or companies?
I'm interested about entity contributing to Debian. So if there's an email, so some email and GPG key which belongs to an entity called foobar LTD, then foobar LTD will be credited. I'm not interested that there is a real person behind this. I'm not interested that that's the real name of a person. It's just whatever is chosen for contribution. That we only check identities when we have to, which is when we've given people upload rights, because we want to know where they live and go there to tickle them if they do something wrong.
So I take it that the main index will be the email? Even behind the scenes, I mean not publicly, but the main index will be the email?
That is an issue. Because depending on the data sources, the index could be an email, in the BTS for example, an Alioth account for commits in Alioth, or Debian developer login name for sponsoring uploads. So possibly there could be some need of mixing things at some point, which is a bit of a separate problem. I don't mind starting with that not being perfect or being fixed by hand. And if we evolve at some point, there may be a way for people to log in and prove that they control that GPG key or that email address or that Alioth account. You know, send an email challenge and say, that's my email. But okay, it is. Yes, okay, then I merge the two sets of contribution. Possibly for next year, because it starts being a bit heavyweight. But there's a problem of doing this collation. It is, however, something that may greatly help the MIA team. So this, in the end, can be something that can be used to detect when people are not contributing anymore. I would also want to make it so that if you are a Debian developer, you are not automatically a Debian contributor. If you're not a Debian developer, you're not automatically a Debian contributor. You are a Debian contributor only if you contribute to Debian. If you are a Debian developer that does not contribute to Debian, then you're not on that list. You keep being a Debian developer. There's the usual, I'm not interested in changing the rules for getting removed from Debian tiering. I think what we have is fine. But it's perfectly all right. If I'm not active in Debian for a year, but I still care about the project, vote, and follow things, but I don't contribute anymore, then I'm perfectly happy that I'm not listed among the contributors for that year. There was a hand?
Yes, I'm relaying a comment from IRC.
Yes.
Wouldn't recognizing every small thing, like just one bug report, dilute the weight of a Debian contributor, that so other Debian contributors, like the head of a translation team, being equal to one bug report?
Yes.
That's the comment. I'm not saying I agree.
The way I see it, again we can, you can tell me if you don't like this, but the way I see it, they are the same. They are Debian contributors. Maybe one has been a Debian contributor for much longer than the other. So the time span of the contribution is the only extra bit. Or you can click on a person and list the contribution. But I don't want to calculate a number of how much one is a contributor. I don't see why one would want to rank people by contribution. I'm not interested in that. I think it creates a kind of community where I don't want to be in. Personally, I mean, that would be my personal feeling. But I would be able to say thank you even if a person reports a bug. It takes time to report a bug. There was an idea while talking about this informally earlier of having some data sources used only to compute the time span but not the status of contributors. For example, mailing list traffic. Many people don't like the idea that if you send an email to a mailing list, you are a Debian contributor. There's indeed many people that send lots of emails to Debian mailing list, but do not contribute to Debian at all. However, if somebody is a contributor for some other reason, then it makes sense to look at mailing list involvement to say, well, you reported back today, but you've been active in mailing lists for a year, so you are a Debian contributor because you reported the bug, and you've been a Debian contributor for a year because you've been into Debian for a long time. So splitting, adding some data sources only used for computing the time and not the status.
I would like to add something about the issue with detecting the people, because we had some experience in the team maintenance thing. And in UDD you have this Carnivore database, which is based on the key fingerprint. And we even have for these people somebody with five different names, spellings, and so on. People are using different email addresses. So I really, really, really doubt you can manage this for, say, more than 500 people. Because it's manual work, and we tried it, and it's hard to cope with this.
No, I don't want to do manual work.
Okay. Good luck with automatic detection.
No, I don't want to do that much automatic detection either. I would like the things to be fixed as much as possible, and at a lower level of data sources. When that is not possible, I would like to offer people a way to fix the data for themselves. There's that unpronounceable and evil website that tracks free software developers, that in my opinion should be illegal but isn't. It starts with O, OLO, O-L-H-O-Y or something like that. I actually had an argument with their CEO saying, I asked to opt out of their system and they told me to fuck off. So, talking about privacy of these things, and I guess if they can do what they do, I think we don't have a problem to say thank you to a bunch of people. They have a mess, their data set is a mess, but people still like them. I'm listed about 20 times in their system, and if I really cared about contributing them my identity for free, for them to sell it out, then I can log in and merge these identities for them. And I guess that's something we can offer. And that can improve things like Carnivore and so on. And possibly we can have personal homepage thingy for contributors.
So they actively contribute to their identification. Okay.
Yeah, at least we've done all we can to thank them. But, if I tell you thank you, I don't expect you to say you didn't thank me in the appropriate way. Right? On the other hand, I'm okay if people say, well, I'm the same person that did this and that, you don't need to thank me so many times. and that's fine. But on the other hand, I'm perfectly happy if people want to use multiple identities for contributing to Debian. Somebody in Debian science may want to contribute to Debian games under a different name. For similar reasons, I don't want to track the time frame of contributions below the month level. I don't want to say, you have contributed to Debian games between 10 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. on a Thursday when you were meeting. Right? So it's, I want it to be coarse. It really needs to be mostly about thank you and about building reputation. It's, reputation is also what we can reward people with, which is kind of the point of the exercise. And that reputation is nice to acknowledge, and at the same time it's nice that we can look up someone's reputation, at least as a debit account manager and front desk member. If I can see what's somebody's reputation and have a reasonable look, then I can make the process much swifter for them. And especially for non-uploading DDs, it's going to be very hard, because I can't go and look at package change logs to see that they've been active for 10 years in the process. And if somebody is a non-uploading DD that has done translations at the moment, I have a very hard time seeing what they've done. Possibly I don't understand the language. And so, well, and that makes it easier. And that another outcome that I would really want to see out of this is that we start to actually see in front of us that Debian is not just about technical development. There's a lot more, but if people still perceive, oh, I'd like to contribute to Debian, but I'm not a technical person. And many of us may have difficulty in pointing out the places, but one can go and have a look at such a list of people and say, hey, look, there's people over there that do all sorts of other stuff. It could be indexed by topic of contribution as well. Again, uploading, these are contributors that do uploading, these are contributors that do translations. That may be introduced at some point, so that we can turn on a spotlight in several aspects of Debian that we don't usually look into, we just take it for granted.
I have another question, Victor.
Yeah?
Another concern more than anything. One thing you said at the beginning is that maybe some people would be quite interested in this for laboral reasons, for work, for creating a curriculum.
Yeah.
And if it's as easy as to find a bug, which can be very hard to do, depending on the bug, or very easy to do,
yeah,
depending on how much you put and stuff, wouldn't be able to be like calling people to put just random stuff or easy stuff there for just being in the list?
Yeah, well, at that point, it really depends on the recruiters. Say that if you have a recruiter that just does a random Google search and contacts whoever comes out, like Google recruiters, I keep being contacted about for things like managing clusters. If anyone's ever looked at what I do, I don't manage clusters, right? So if there's poor recruiters like that, there's nothing you can do. If people care to actually go in and to look at what a person has done, then there's a way to find out what contributions actually were, from just linking to the usual Debian mailing list archives or uploads or commit logs and so on.
So, if I understand correctly, you are ready to use the BTS as a source for the contributors, and you could have a lot of nicknames there. Could be the Pope or Bill Gates or the name of a serial killer or whatever. Are you ready to use that? Maybe there could be some issue with people that would be falsely credited?
Well, we try and see what happened. What happens? It could be that for the backtracking system, we need to have some extra intelligence built in to avoid crediting China Manufacturing Corporation or Viagra supplies for cheap. mailing list archives are despammed, somehow, but again, then maybe maybe there's lots of noise, and we want to set a threshold that one contribution to the bug tracking system is not going to be enough. Or maybe we can look if that bug was closed, no, because you close spam bugs. Anyway, if there's craft, if there's noise, then we can filter somehow, and maybe we lose some contributions. But at least it wasn't for a lack of trying. I mean, I don't want to go out of my way to thank someone. I mean, if I need to find out where you live to come to your home and say thank you because I don't see you anymore, then, or because I met you in a crowded square and you gave me directions but I didn't take down your phone number, then it's unfair, you won't be thanked when I finally reach my destination, but that's life. So, yeah, then maybe it takes 10 emails to the BTS with different content to be acknowledged. But it's possibly something to be... I would leave freedom to the people doing an import thing, something that gets data out of the backtracking system. Give that area freedom to work it out, and I don't want anyone to be perfect. The system is not going to be perfect. If somebody would really like to be credited but isn't in the list, and what they do is report bugs, I would be surprised, because if somebody wants to be credited and only reported one bug, I can say, well, just report some more. I'm not sure I want to have people in Debian that contribute in order to be credited. If contributing some more is a way to get you credited, then yeah, we don't need to be perfect, we just ask people to contribute some more. Or if people contribute, the problem is when people contribute a lot, but they are not credited, then maybe we need to figure out how to import data from another part of Debian that we currently don't track so well. I'm totally not looking for perfection here.
Have you thought about other ways to use mailing list archive? Because well, you said we don't always want to use it as a source of contribution, but more to track the length of contribution. But there are some lists, for example, L10A translation list,
mm-hmm.
where I guess most people who contribute are real contributors, and sometimes they also use some code. I mean, the email could be identified, like a request for review and stuff
mm-hmm.
like that. So you can have some hints on the type of contribution, more precise than just send a mail to the mailing list. And maybe also for a user mailing list, not tracking the question, but only answers, or sorts like that. Because, well, asking a question is not a real contribution to the event, but helping someone else to
yeah.
use the event system is real contribution, and one of the most important ones to start with, I guess.
Decoding mailing list patterns fairly is not easy as far as I understand, and I guess it changes from list to list, but that could be solved by adding a general mailing list source that only looks at time frame, and having the translation team saying, in our mailing list, there's more semantic information that can be extracted. So I'll make an extra importer for my team that decodes things and put it there properly. As long as you can have many things dumping data into a bucket, then that works. I currently have no idea, well, only vague ideas on what's the protocol to collect this data. I would from the central bit, I wouldn't go much further than having a list of URLs from where I download something on a regular basis, because that's the simplest protocol to identify instead of submits and whatnot. And what's in the file that gets downloaded could be identity, initial time, final time. And then each data source makes a file available somewhere. I was thinking of something super simple-minded like that, but then it's not enough, because then if you want to look to make a link showing the contributions, then well, that needs something about how to make this data available for collection. At the central point, I want it as simple-minded as possible. I don't want the core of this to be about data collection, about mining. It should just be about collecting what has been mined.
One last question.
Just a thought on what you said. There is a Google Summer of Code project on the fed message, which is very basically maybe to have a bus collecting lots of information from various sorts of information. Among those, there's already monitors.dev.net. I guess the BTS will be.
Mentors?
It's a source.
More like events.
Yeah, but I guess those events could have enough metadata like identify the person. The software is fed message, FEDMSG, it's from Fedora, and the Summer of Code student is trying to adapt it for Debian. Just a software bus where you collect, you get lots of events from various sources. And maybe it could be assuming that it goes further than this summer,
mm-hmm.
It could be an interesting use of this project.
Okay.
As the mentor of this project, I agree.
Who's the mentor?
I am.
We should talk.
And I think the student is arriving today, so. So we're out of time, so thank you, Enrico.
We can talk about this. I plan to work on it during the DevConf. Shortly, there should be Martin Ferrari coming, who was also intending to work on a site similar to this. And I guess we should all get together and think of something. And feel free to stop me to talk about this and offer help or. That's the main thing I want to do at DevConf. And I want to get something done before the end of the DevConf so we can present it properly.